Good day, students. In this clip, we're going to be going over how to find the area of the triangle using trigonometry. So let's go ahead and take a look at the formulas that we're going to be using to find the areas, and then we'll apply them to the three examples, okay? So let's write down the formulas. So there are three cases, three groups of cases that we're going to be looking at. The first one is the SAS situation. If you have a side, two sides and an included angle, SAS, the formula for the area in this case is simply 1/2 AB sine C, okay? Where the included angle, obviously, you can see is C. Or another way you can look at this is 1/2 of the side times the side times the sine of the included angle, which is represented by A, okay? All right, so SAS is very easy because when you have an SAS situation, all you simply do is plug in the two sides and the included angle into this equation, and you're done, okay? When you have an SSS situation, you cannot use trigonometry for this. You have to use a special formula known as Heron's formula. For this case, the area is given by the square root of the semi-perimeter S times the semi-perimeter minus A times the semi-perimeter minus B times the semi-perimeter minus C, okay? You might wonder, what is a semi-perimeter? The semi-perimeter is just what you get when you add the three sides, A plus B plus C, and divide it by 2, all right? So this is the first case, pretty straightforward. The second case is also pretty straightforward. But what if we have SSA? SSA is equivalent to ASS, whichever way you want to look at it. Or if we have AAS, which is equivalent to SAA. What if we have these situations right here? Well, if you have these cases, what you have to do is you have to convert these cases into an SAS situation using, you can use law of sines. Okay, that's very convenient. Using law of sines, all right? And when you convert these into an SAS situation, then you simply use the SAS formula to finish the problem off. Okay, so these are the cases we're going to be looking at. All right, so let's take a look at question number one. For question one, we're to find the area of this triangle right here. So let's label all the sides, the relevant sides. This is uppercase A, so I'm gonna call this lowercase a. This is uppercase B, so I'll call this lowercase B. This is uppercase C. I don't really need lowercase c in this problem. You'll see why in a minute. Now recall, SAS situation is very easy and direct, right? SSS requires the use of the Heron's formula, and then the other ones require more work. So what configuration do we have here? Can you determine what it is? Well, let's see. We have a side, and we have an angle, and we have a side. This is excellent because this is an SAS situation, which requires very little work because we have everything that we need, okay? All right, so let's write down the formula for the area here. So for number one, the area is going to be 1/2 SS sine A. The two S's are A and B. Sine, the included angle is uppercase C. Okay, let me partition my workspace here so we don't get confused. This is a region area for the formulas, and I'm going to put my solutions to the left, all right? Okay, so now we have the formula written down. Now we're going to apply the formula to this triangle. All right, so we're going to have A is equal to 1/2. A is 11. P is 13. Sine 106. Okay? And then if you plug this in your calculator, we're going to be rounding this to the nearest tenth. Your answer is going to be approximately 68.7 square kilometers, kilometers square. All right, so that will be your area. All right, let's take a look at question number two. All right, so what situation do we have here? Well, let's label what we have. We have a side, we have an angle, and we have an angle. Okay, this is a SAA or AAS situation. All right, so what are we going to do here? Well, it requires some work. As indicated earlier, if we have SSAAS or SAA, we have to convert it into an SAS situation so we can apply this formula, okay? So let's see, which side do you want to find? Well, it depends on the angle that you want to use, okay? So let's say we want to use SAS. Let's say we want to find this side right here, this side, okay? So let's label the triangle, and then we can isolate the side we want to find and express it using a variable. All right, so if this is uppercase Y, this would be lowercase y right here. This is Y. And this side right here is going to be what? This side is going to be lowercase x, okay? So this is SAS. Now we have to use law of sines here in order to find little x, right? So in order to use law of sines, we're going to be setting up pairs, two pairs. The first pair, we must know the measure of the side and the angle and the opposite angle. The second pair, we must know either the side or the angle. All right, so in this case, we want to find little x. So we're going to be using the formula. Let's start with what we're looking for. X over sine of big X equals, now the next, I chose this pair because I'm looking for x, okay? The next pair I'm going to select, I must know both the upper lowercase, all right? So let's see which pair satisfies that. We have the y's, we know both the angle and the side. So we're going to have little y over sine of big Y, okay? All right, if you notice in this equation, I must have only one unknown. The only unknown that's permissible is lowercase x. How about this big X right here? Can I determine what the value of this angle is? The answer is absolutely. We can use elementary geometry to determine this angle because the sum of the angles in a triangle is 180. Okay? So to find a big X, a big X is equal to 180 minus the sum of the other two, 57. Plus 102. Okay? Now, if you do the calculations, you find out that uppercase X is equal to 21 degrees. So let's put that in there, 21 degrees. Alright, so what are we looking for again? We want to find little x, so we have an SAS situation, and we can find the area. So let's plug everything in this formula right here. So we're going to have little x over sine of big X, which is 21. Equals little y, which is 8, over sine of big Y, which is 57. To get x by itself, we'll multiply both sides by sine 21. If you plug this entire expression in your calculator, you have little x equals 3.4184. Okay? So let's put that in our triangle. Little s is 3.418. All right, is that our answer? The answer is no. We just found one side. The problem asks us to look for the area, okay? So what are we using here? We want to use SAS, right? SAS, that's what we're going to use for the formula. So we use y, big Z, and little x, okay? So to find the area, let's partition our workspace again so we don't get confused. I'm going to be looking for the area right here. It's not log anymore. So the area A is going to be 1/2 SS sine A. So S is Y. The other S is X sine of the included angle, which is uppercase Z. All right? So let's input the values. So we have 1/2 Y, which is 8, X, which is 3.418, sine Z, which is 102. All right? If we plug all this into our calculator, we'll have the approximate value of 13.4 square inches, or inches square. All right, so that's the area for the triangle in number 2. All right, let's take a look at number 3. What situation do we have here? For number 3, we have a side, side, and a side. This is SSS. Okay? So what formula do we use here? Remember, in this case, we can't use trigonometry because we don't have any of the angles, so we're going to have to use Heron's formula. Alright, so let's recollect what Heron's formula is. Again, Heron's formula for the area of a triangle given SSS is going to be the semi-perimeter S times the square root of, semi-perimeter goes inside. Let's write this again. So we have area equals the square root of the semi-perimeter S times S minus. In this case, this is uppercase P, so we're going to call this lowercase p. This is uppercase R, we call this lowercase r. This is uppercase Q, so we call this lowercase Q. So it's going to be S minus lowercase p times S minus lowercase Q times S minus lowercase r. Okay? So this is the area formula. So let's figure out what the semi-perimeter is. Semi-perimeter is the sum of the three sides P plus Q plus R divided by 2. Okay? So let's input the values. We're going to have 12 plus this Q. Q is 4. 12 plus 4 plus 12 divided by 2. All right? If you add this all up, you're going to have 12 plus 12 is 24 plus 4 is 28. Okay, 28 divided by 2, you get 14. So that's your semi-perimeter. So we're ready to plug everything into the formula. So we're going to have A, the area of this SSS triangle equals the semi-perimeter, which is 14, times 14 minus P, 14 minus 12, times 14, the semi-perimeter minus Q, which is 4 times 14, which is the semi-perimeter minus 12. All right, so that's the expression. All right, and then this, if we simplify this, we'll have the square root of 14 times 14 minus 2 is 2, 14 minus 4 is 10, 14 minus 12 again is 2, okay? And if you work this out, your exact area is going to be the square root of 560, which is approximately 23.7, what's the unit here? Miles square. All right, so this is your area using the Heron's formula. Okay, so that's that. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. You can feel free to subscribe to my channel by clicking up here. And please post a comment to let me know what you think about this presentation. More clips can be found on mathgotserved.com. Thanks again for watching and have a wonderful day.